Live from Vienna, Austria, it's theCUBE. Covering .NEXT Europe 2016. Brought to you by Nutanix. Here's your host, Stu Miniman.
Welcome back. Getting towards the end of SiliconANGLE's theCUBE's coverage of Nutanix.next 2016, the first European show here in Vienna, Austria. Happy to welcome back to the program Julie O'Brien, who's the Vice President of Corporate Marketing at Nutanix.
That's right.
Julie, how's it going?
Oh man, it's been so much fun. You can tell I've lost my voice. It's just one of those weeks, right? Apparently,
yeah. We
only go to places that begin with V, since the last time I saw you, we were in Vegas.
Yeah, absolutely. So, Julie, first of all, I mean, kudos to your team. This event, I think, is bigger than it was in Miami last year.
Yeah, that's right.
And, you know, way over kind of initial expectations. How many people, how many countries?
What's the conference? So Miami was our inaugural event for a user conference, and so we sort of put the goal out there for the team to say, okay, I think you can either meet or beat the numbers in Miami, which we ended up with about 960 people in Miami. So coming into Vienna, you know, we really didn't know what that was going to look like, but that was our target. And I'm really excited to say, it's a good challenge to have. We ended up with 1,242 people who joined us. So, as you can imagine, when you're planning an event and you're thinking, oh, probably 900 to 1,000, and then you've got a whole bunch of extra folks who show up, it's super exciting, but also like, where are we going to put everyone? How are we going to fit everyone in the breakout sessions? But that represented 33 different verticals, or different vertical industries, and people coming from 54 different countries. Yeah.
And Julie, give us a lay of the land a little, because an event like this, you know, there's morning keynotes, there's breakouts, but you have lots of little pieces inside for various constituencies.
So .NEXT has kind of become, you know, it's one big event with many events inside of it, right? So we have our .NOW program, which is all for our channel partners. That was a half day before .NEXT started. We love having our channel partners be part of sort of the ecosystem and the audience here, talking with customers and sort of soaking in all of the breakout tracks. We have opening keynotes, closing keynotes. We had some great speakers. I think some of them you had on theCUBE. Dr. Art Langer, who's from Columbia University, talks about digital disruption. He's a lot of fun. Closing out today's session is going to be Nassim Nicholas Taleb, who wrote Anti-Fragility.
And Black Swan.
And Black Swan as well.
We've been talking about Black Swan events a little bit this week.
Yeah.
Really fascinating read. I've got Black Swan, haven't gotten Anti-Fragility yet, but
yeah,
it's definitely on my reading list.
Yeah, it's good stuff. And he was just with me over in the exec track. So then we do, during the course of 2 days, an executive track as well, and bring in some of the keynote speakers and some other speakers in a more intimate setting for the folks who are really running infrastructure and thinking about some of the challenges, not only from a technology standpoint, but even kind of like a geopolitical standpoint as well. We do executive briefings. We have our NX files, which is sort of a sneak peek roadmap session. So we kind of show what's under the covers at Nutanix and what the engineers are up to, what you might see in future product releases. So lots of things going on over the course of 2 days that actually makes it feel more like a week, but it's all compressed into about 2 days.
So the cadence you expect to continue with like a U.S. show, you know, kind of in the spring and in the fall, you'll do a European or non-U.S. show, I guess.
Yeah, so this 2017 will be June in Washington, D.C., and hopefully we'll see you there. And then in November, I can't unveil it right now, but I will be shortly, where we'll be for .NEXT Europe next year.
We're looking forward to that announcement. I hear it will be a good place.
It will be a good place.
Yeah. Excellent. So, also, you know, maybe give us a little bit, you know, putting this together. I mean, you so many pieces, you know, just the logistics, you know, the speakers. You guys had a really fun party last night.
Thank you.
A little bit of local flavor.
Yeah.
And the pyrotechnics and fireworks at the end.
Yeah.
Were fun. But,
thank you. Yeah. I mean, so hats off to the whole events team and the European team for all of the hard work that they put into making this successful. And I think it is special when you come to a really unique and beautiful city like Vienna. You want to give people the opportunity to experience it, because let's face it, sometimes when we come to these conferences, we don't get a chance to go out and do as much sightseeing. We don't get to participate as a tourist. So we do our best to try to infuse some of that to, we bring, you know, Vienna inside the conference to you.
That's great. I mean, I go to Las Vegas so much. It's like I get to a show there every other year out of the 20 times I go,
yeah.
As opposed to Vienna. Right, the music, the art, the food, the culture, the history. I mean, it was fascinating.
Yeah, I was actually hoping for a little snow, but yeah. I don't know if it's gonna happen for us.
Depends when you're leaving. I hear they've been talking about some flurries, but yeah, it's a little cold for some of the West Coast people coming from the U.S.
Yeah, bundle up.
So, just broader in marketing, I saw you've got obviously activities on the event itself, but a couple hashtags I've seen going around. Something my way, something like that.
On my terms.
On my terms,
right?
So
that's something we've really been talking a lot about with customers and trying to demonstrate the value that Nutanix brings, right? So you'll hear Sunil and Dheeraj talk about the enterprise cloud, right? But what does it mean to have the enterprise cloud on my terms? And so we've invited customers and channel partners to tweet out what they think that means, what it means to them, right? And how Nutanix is helping them free up time, make it easier for them to do upgrades and migrations so that they can spend more time playing Frisbee with the dog or hang out with their kids instead of having to babysit an infrastructure upgrade. So it's been really fun to see the kind of feedback that's happened from both customers as well as channel partners talking about and appreciating what it means to have an enterprise cloud on my terms, on their terms.
The other one, the dot heart activities here, and you had some events in the show, maybe you can talk about those.
Yeah, so Nutanix has talked a lot about being hungry, humble, and honest. And hopefully you heard Dheeraj mention this too, but it's really also about having heart. And we've been doing a lot as a company over the last, I would say, 3 years or so around women in tech and girls in tech in particular. And we've formalized a role, a corporate social responsibility role. It's on my team. And are really making a very concerted effort to not only have a voice in the marketplace around our views and our opinions around diversity and women in tech, but also to do some really strong contributions as well. And so sometimes that'll be around women in tech or girls in tech, and sometimes it's around just another initiative or area of opportunity. So here we were doing, I think, 300 backpacks for children in need. And so it was really fantastic to see all the customers, channel partners, sponsors, participating and getting all those backpacks ready to go.
So. Yeah, I love to see it. As someone that goes to way too many conferences, I've usually been like, hey, is there a way I can donate this?
Yeah.
So that's
a little less swag
to give back. Yeah.
And a little more opportunity to give back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm definitely in full support of that. Okay. I'm curious, Julie, Nutanix, you've been with Nutanix for a while. You're now a public company. Mm-hmm. People are calling up, asking about, what's different, being in marketing for Nutanix as opposed to the, who's that, Nutanix, type company to like, oh, hey,
yes.
that new public company doing the hyper-convergence Apple strudel something.
So I think, obviously one of the benefits of going public is that you do get more of that public awareness and air cover around your company and hopefully the correct way to pronounce your company, right? But also, I think that from a marketing perspective, and really across the company in general, it really is viewed as one point in a journey. So a lot of us were in at NASDAQ on September 29th and 30th, right? That Friday for the big event. On Monday morning, it was sort of back to business as usual, and it's really amazing, and I think really. Satisfying that the team just feels so connected in terms of what we're building together, that it really just is, that one point in time with a whole journey in front of us. So.
Yeah. And how does Nutanix look at marketing globally? Do you have a lot of localization efforts? Does the marketing team span globally?
Yeah, it does. Actually, not too long ago, we brought on a head of marketing for Europe, Mark Lewis. I don't know if you're going to have a chance to meet with him or speak with him.
Yeah, so unfortunately, he won't be on the program, but okay. I do know Mark Lewis, and I know the other Mark Lewis that he used to get confused with at a company that Mark and I both worked at together.
Pretty funny,
In the storage world.
Okay,
so yeah,
great.
It's a small world out there.
Well, I think he's the only Mark Lewis at Nutanix, so hopefully that won't happen. But EMEA as well as APJ, really important for us. We're operating, I think last count was like 90 countries globally, and so being international is really important. I think even if you read the Gartner Magic Quadrant, you'll see that we've gotten props for how quickly we've globalized as an organization. Anything that we publish out there, we're publishing in multiple languages, and we definitely appreciate the opportunity to hear from customers everywhere.
Yeah. Awesome. Julie, want to give you the opportunity. Anything, you know, we walked through a bunch of pieces of the show, things that people that didn't come here in person, what you'd want them to know about, take away from the .next Europe show.
Yeah, sure. So the good news is if you didn't come, a lot of this is streaming, thanks to your help on that too. So we have all the general sessions that were being streamed. They'll also be available as video on demand. Many of the breakout tracks will also be available. And one of the things that we do after each big .next conference is we package up kind of the best of the opening keynote with the best of some of the breakout sessions, and we bring that on the road. So for people who weren't able to attend in Vienna, I'll be back on December 1st in Paris. So I look forward to seeing you there.
That's a tough one.
Yeah. Someone had to do it. And then we have what's called our X-Tour as part of that, which are a bunch of seminar series that also run in smaller cities.
Yeah, I think you're actually in Boston this week. So
We're in Boston concurrently right now. Yeah. So there's a great opportunity, I think, to still engage in the content. And there was a press release with some of the news, so please get out there and read up and join us where you can.
Yeah, so Julie, I've got one final question for
yes.
you.
Know,
so you're a Patriots fan.
I am a Patriots fan.
So I'm curious, there are, you know, those are the people that are Patriot fans and those people that, you know, don't love a winner. So I'm curious, as, you know, now Nutanix, you know, there are people that are very enthusiastic and supportive, mm-hmm. like the people here at the conference, mm-hmm. And then there's people that watch Nutanix mm-hmm. and tend to throw stones. What's your take on kind of the external people that, you know, maybe are not fans of Nutanix or maybe don't understand what you guys stand for?
Yeah. So, boy, I have to channel like my inner Tom Brady or something for this, right? I think that, you know, we're really, really passionate about our customers and our products. If you talk to any of our customers or our channel partners, you get that sense from them. And that's one of the awesome things about .next. You just feel it. There's just a vibe that's in the air of like that's just passionate people coming together around solving enterprise cloud problems. So I would just say, you know, we're true to who we are. We're hungry, we're humble, we're honest. And if you haven't seen that from Nutanix, you know, get to know us. It's true.
Well, yeah, I'll channel the inner Bill Belichick and it's like .next on to D.C.
Yeah, that's
is
right.
There,
it's
but,
done
you know,
and now we're on.
Congratulations on everything to you and the team. I know a ton of hard work. We really appreciate the partnership that we've
likewise.
Had with theCUBE to be able to be at all these shows.
Thank you.
Look forward to future events.
All right, we'll see you in DC.
All right. Julie O'Brien with Nutanix here, getting towards the end of our coverage of Nutanix.next 2016 in Vienna, Austria. You're watching theCUBE.